Hosanna! Hosanna in the highest. Today is Palm Sunday, and so we have our palm. And we request you that as we sing our opening hymn, Hosanna, what's the title? Hosanna, loud Hosanna, let us wave our palms high. But we will start our worship service with our breath prayer, giving thanks to the King who is coming, who has come, and is with us right now. Let us pray all together. Hosanna, amen.
When Jesus came into town, it was like Taylor Swift and March Madness all rolled together. So let's be excited and sing Hosanna. I see the King of Glory coming on the clouds with fire. The whole earth shakes, I see His love and mercy washing over all our sin. The people sing, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna. Generation rising up to take their place with selfless faith, I see a near revival stirring as we pray and seek. We're on our knees, Hosanna. Let's continue our worship and shout to the Lord.
My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength, let every breath, all that I am, never cease to worship you. Shout to the Lord, all the earth, let us sing. your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength, let every breath, all that I am, never cease to worship you. Shout to the Lord, all the earth, let us sing. Power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down and the seas will roar at the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the works of your hands. Forever I'll love you, forever I'll stand. Nothing compares to the promise I have in you.
Well, thank you, Pam and Carolyn and Erica. Taylor could not have done that any better. Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome. Welcome to Bethel Wesley United Methodist Church, whether you're here in the sanctuary or for those of you viewing online, we welcome you. Thank you for joining us in our worship. And today is an important day in the church calendar, isn't it? Yes, the day, it's Palm Sunday, and that's the day that Jesus rode into Bethlehem, the unexpected king. But I think that's your topic, isn't it? Yeah, coming up. Today is also an important day for another reason. There's only, according to the church records here, there's only one birthday left in the month. So I checked online just to see what events of epic proportion had taken place on March 24th throughout history. Uh-huh. Turns out there's only three. In 1958, Elvis Presley was inducted into the United States Army. Woohoo! In 1989, the Exxon Valdez crashed into the coast of Alaska, spilling millions of gallons of oil. And in 2002, Halle Berry won the Best Actress Oscar for her role in Monsters Ball. It was notable because she was the first black actress to win the Best Actress Award. So that's it, those three, that's all. Yes. So the good news is, I'll get to that. In my lifetime, this is the seventh time since I've been born that Palm Sunday has fallen on March 24th. So in leap year terms, that makes me seven palms old. You figure it out. Okay, what's up at Bethel Wesley? There really is a stellar event happening tonight at Bethel Wesley. This is the benefit concert, and you all have a flyer in your bulletins today. If you didn't come last year, you really missed an awesome concert, and I know it'll be the same. And I guess this year it also includes dancers. Would that include line dancing?
No, next year. Nah.
Yeah. No line dancing, but there will be dancers featured tonight. There is also a host of Easter activities coming up this week. The last of the Lenten studies will be this Wednesday at 5:30. It doesn't matter if you've attended previously or not. This is a really fun group to have discussion with. On Thursday, there's a Maundy-Thursday dinner at 5:30.
No.
It's hard to keep up with this church, isn't it? Okay, it's not at 5:30, it's at 12 o'clock noon. Okay, before I say anything about the Good Friday retreat, then has the time changed for that? 5:30 for the Good Friday retreat. And then on Easter, there is the morning coffee hour that starts at 8:30. Are there any announcements that I have missed?
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
What does that retreat mean for Good Friday?
It's the Stations of the Cross.
At the coffee hour, we're also going to be serving fresh fruit and sweet breads.
The coffee hour that starts on 8:30 will also be serving fresh fruits and sweet bread. Denny. Okay, if you didn't hear that, there is a short trustees meeting following the church service, and I think it's to discuss fire alarms in the elevators. Any other announcements? Chris?
Last day to order hot pies, so yummy, yummy.
Okay, Chris just extended the day. I looked, it was last Friday, so it just got extended to today. Your last day to order pecan pies. Anybody else? Hold on a second, I don't know what's next. Okay, would you all join me for the call of adoration, please? And stand if you're able. In joy, we gather this day.
Hosanna to Jesus the Christ.
In remembrance, we gather this day.
Hosanna to the Son of David.
In festive celebration and quiet reflection, we gather to worship and pray.
Hosanna to the Son of God.
And if you would please join me in the opening prayer. Jesus, you have walked this road with us many times. Guide our steps and keep us close. Inspire our worship with your loving presence and work in our lives that your Spirit may flow through our lives as we seek to help others walk the journey with you. Amen. And our first hymn will be Hosanna, Loud Hosanna in United Methodist Hymnal number 278. Okay, this is the time in our service when we ask that you share any joys that you may have or any concerns that you may have. Let's start with the joys first. Any joys to share? First of all, Bobby, it's good to see you back. Missed you, man. Good to see you. John. Yeah, John asked for prayers for their daughter-in-law, Ashley, as she prepares to deliver the second grandchild this Wednesday. Others. Okay, Jill shares both a joy and sorrow for the passing of Larry Fearkolb, am I pronouncing?
Kolb.
Who passed this Thursday in hospice and thanks us for the prayers that we shared for him during that time. Others? Sandy? Yeah, Sandy shares a joy because the Learning Center really does do amazing things. They have, I think it was 4 new students last week, Burma, Afghanistan, I can't even remember the countries, but these people come with nothing, really, in reality, with the clothes on their back. And what we try to do, or the Learning Center tries to do, is readjust them into the American way of life by giving them basic English and social skills that enable them to function in the American life. And a concern, because we do have some financial issues with the status of the Learning Center that we are working through. Any others? Ed. Ed, you are in such trouble. Yeah, Ed and Pam, and actually, is that on the 29th?
Yes.
That is amazing, because Becky and I will actually celebrate our anniversary also on the 29th, but I will just list that as a joy, Ed. Well done. Any other joys or concerns? I think you've all, Carolyn.
Alfonso, who runs one of the schools that we support, is quite ill and finally got a diagnosis of bleeding ulcers. And so hopefully he's on the mend. And Connie Witherspoon, Connie Witherspoon, who she changed her name.
Okay, Carolyn, I guess it's a joy for Alfonso if he is recovering from a bleeding ulcer, and for Connie Witherspoon, who overcame the breast cancer but now has cervical cancer. Is that?
Yes.
Okay. Wow. Bob.
Yeah, my brother.
Bob Hansky asked for prayers for Frank Jones, his brother-in-law, who had a leg amputated and continues to have some bleeding issues. So we will lift Frank up in our prayers. Maggie. I'm sorry, Max is not well enough to travel?
Yeah, he's concerned about traveling, so he's staying home.
Okay, Maggie lifts Max has some concerns about traveling, and so you're going to travel, and he's going to stay home. Okay. So does that mean you're going to change from like country western music to like WVIK or what? No. No, I think you will enjoy condo life very much. Are there any others?
Let's pray for traveling mercies for our artists. Two will come from East Alton, two will come from Iowa City, and three is coming from Macomb. So, and the ladies from who will dance are somewhere here in Quad Cities. But then let's pray for their traveling mercies and all the people who's coming tonight for our concert. And another concern, please continue to pray for Joanne's father, Tatay Fred. It is a liver problem, and since he doesn't have American insurance, they are asked to ask for help to have a government hospital to take care of him. So, and it's just so overwhelming for her to be in this situation, Joanne. They were told that Tatay Fred's liver is functioning only 18% right now. So let's pray. But if you ask him, he said, "I'm okay, I don't feel any pain." And he's looking for me. When is Janice coming to visit me? So I told them, because they said, try to drive to Chicago. So I told them, tell Tatay Fred, if I will drive to Chicago, I might be beside him on the award if I do that. Anyway, so let's pray for those who are in that situation right now. Shall we come to God in prayer? Eternal God, grant us the humility like our Lord Jesus, and grant that we may ever obey and serve you by showing love for one another as he has shown love to us. Put in our minds and in our hearts his eternal example, and guide us in the way of peace. Lord, hear our prayer. Most loving God, help us be ones who care for those who suffer, to remember that those who are afflicted are often innocent of wrongdoing, and that those who are persecuted are often without guilt or sin. Help us to have a heart of compassion, a tongue that utters words of forgiveness and love, and hands that perform works of healing. Lord, hear our prayer. Assist us, O God, to be more expressive in our relationship with you, to show your boundless generosity through our own caring. Grant us, O Lord, the courage in obedience to you and strength in our service. Make us ever mindful of the sin that leads to death and of righteousness that leads to life. And help us to trust you, not in ourselves. Hear our prayers, the prayers of our heart, the concerns and joys that we offer to you right now. May we always find the way to praise you and honor you in all of our days, in our joys and in our concerns. Most loving God, we thank you for our Lord Jesus Christ, who offered himself, who who offers peace for us. And we pray in his name, who taught us how to pray the Lord's Prayer.
Our scripture reading today comes from the book of Psalms, chapter 118, verses 1 through 2, and verses 19 through 29. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let Israel say, his love endures forever. And continuing with verses 19 through 29. Open for me the gates of the righteous. I will enter and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord through which the righteous may enter. I will give you thanks, for you answered me. You have become my salvation. The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The Lord has done this, and it is marvelous in our eyes. The Lord has done it this very day. Let us rejoice today and be glad. Lord, save us. Lord, grant us success. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. From the house of the Lord, we bless you. The Lord is God, and he has made his light shine on us. With boughs in hand, join in the festal procession up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, and I will exalt you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever.
May I invite those who are able to please stand as I read the gospel according to Mark chapter 11, verse 1 to 11. And I'm reading from the Good News Translation. As they approached Jerusalem near the towns of Bethphage and Bethany, they came to the Mount Olives. Jesus sent two of his disciples on ahead with these instructions. Go to the village there ahead of you. As soon as you get there, you will find a colt tied up that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. And if someone asks you why you are doing that, say that the master needs it and will send it back at once. So they went and found a colt out in the street, tied to the door of a house. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders asked them, "What are you doing, untying that colt?" They answered just as Jesus had told them, and the crowd let them go. They brought the colt to Jesus, threw their cloaks over the animal, and Jesus got on. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, while others cut branches in the field and spread them on the road. The people who were in front and those who followed him began to shout, "Praise God! God bless him who comes in the name of the Lord. God bless the coming kingdom of King David, our father. Praise be to God." Jesus entered Jerusalem, went into the temple, and looked around at everything. But since it was already late in the day, he went out to Bethany with the 12 disciples. This is the gospel of the Lord. There is a show, a segment of Michael McIntyre's big show entitled Unexpected Star of the Show. Has anyone watched it? You can find it in YouTube. It showcases ordinary people with great singing talents. The person is set up, usually by a friend or a family member. They will write the show, and they will pick them up, and they will set them up and lure to a particular location under false pretense. Like one said, they were given a free tour to London, something like that. Or there was one who is an athlete. He has to be what they call that, an influencer. And so he was invited to speak to a couple of youth upcoming sports fan. But it was just at the back of this big white auditorium. And at the end, or in the middle of that show, that person is invited in front of the crowd to perform in front of the Britain's national TV with a live audience. All the people, especially the audience, are expecting to find or to see a great singer for that time, except the person who is invited to do that. But usually, the person will give in to the performance, and they have all the clothes and the backup singers and dancer, and at the end of the show, it would be a spectacular performance. In our gospel reading today, Mark, not the birthday boy, but Mark from the gospel, showcased Jesus not as an unexpected star of the show, but as the unexpected king. Jesus, the unexpected king, came riding a colt. They brought, as we have heard written in Mark 11, 7 to 8, and I have read it to you, they brought the colt to Jesus, threw their cloaks over the animals, and Jesus got on. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, while others cut branches in the field and spread them on the road. Jesus rides in a colt in the city of Jerusalem, and in his time, when a king is going to a war, he would ride a mighty horse. But when the king is going inside or in a parade, he proclaiming him as a king of peace, he will ride a donkey. So like that's the sign of those times. Well, Jesus enhanced that statement of peace by not only choosing a donkey, he chose an unridden colt, a young unridden horse, which signifies Jesus as a peaceful servant king. The Jews, as we all know by now, are expecting a warrior king. It is in the context that they have been conquered by many other nations. They were exiled and they were out in their own places or homes. So they longed for a mighty warrior. They expected a warrior king that would defeat all enemies and conquer their kingdoms, just like what those other kings had done to them. But Jesus came as the unexpected king. The people did not know yet that this unexpected king would defeat the enemy of all enemies, death. But for them, they want the natural way or the very present way that there would be a crowned king with all its helmets and battalion of warriors to charge and defeat people or other nations. But Jesus, when he came to Jerusalem, he didn't bring violence. Jesus would defeat enemies, not by violence, but through peace. Jesus came not to conquer kingdoms, he came to conquer hearts. That's the very big difference of the Messiah that the Jews are waiting for. But then, maybe because of the disciples shouting Hosanna, all other crowds have gathered. I just imagine it's like this big fan club that the leaders of the club will shout, and all other followers will shout, even though they don't know what they're shouting at or what shouting for. The verse says that people shout Hosanna. In verse 9 to 10, it says, many people spread, oops, 9, those in front of him and those following were shouting, Hosanna, blessings on the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessings on the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest. They were longing for a king just like David on that glorious day of David when he would conquer everyone or kingdoms around him. That's the kind of king they wanted. And so they thought when the 12 disciples just shouted Hosanna, oh, so is this the new king? And it's just my imagination. And so they shouted Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. This statement, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, is a psalm of enthronement. It is a regular verse, as we have heard when Mark read Psalms 118. It is a psalm that is used when a king comes into power. Like it's a welcome greeting that here comes the new king. So let us rejoice. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna was a common word in royal psalms, and most people understood it to be a statement of celebration, a shout of joy and welcome. But originally, Hosanna means save us. Save now. Therefore, the Hosanna that the disciples is saying, here comes the Savior. It can be a cry of help, but also a declaration of faith. A declaration of faith at the same time when we say Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. It is a recognition that the coming king is the Savior himself, not another mighty warrior. And so I just wonder, what do people mean or understood when they welcomed Jesus with their loud Hosanna? Was it just a shout of celebration, we have a new king? Or a shout of allegiance to the Savior? But that question would be answered this Holy Week. We know that most of the people who shouted Hosanna is the same people who shouted, crucify him. And how is it for us today? How do you expect Jesus to conquer your battles? What kind of Hosanna do you shout? Second, the unexpected king reigns. Oops. But one thing for sure, Jesus comes to us in unexpected ways. Second, the unexpected king reigns with the people. Verse 11 says, Jesus entered Jerusalem, went into the temple, and looked around at everything. But since it was already late in the day, he went out to Bethany with the 12 disciples. In royal parades, and even right now, the parade ends with the king back to his throne in the palace. And from his palace, he continues to govern and reigns. When Jesus went to the temple and looked around, it was like the king going to his palace. Symbolically, the Messiah enthroned in that temple. But wait! Jesus did not claim the throne in the temple. He did not stay in the temple. He went out to Bethany. He went out to the people with his disciples. The unexpected king reigns with the people. He is not in the high, secluded throne where people cannot reach him. He walks, talks, and dines with the people, especially to those people whom no one wants to talk with, to walk with, or to eat with. He reigns with all kinds of people. There was a pop song in the 1990s, maybe you can relate, a song entitled From a Distance, sung by Bette Midler. And I still remember I was in senior high school then, that one of our teachers even told us, showed us how to do the sign language. From a distance, God is watching us. And I was so happy that I know how to sign language it, but now I beg to disagree. God is not in a distant place. God is with us in this place. God is with us right now. And definitely, God is with us wherever we go. And I firmly believe, even in our darkest moments, in our darkest places, God is with us. And more so, I believe, when we are going, or when we are in that darkest place, he is so near to us. That's why the moment we shout the real Hosanna, saying, save us, Lord, God immediately saves. Because the Savior is just beside us. Not from a distant place. Not in a far distance. And so I hope that as we celebrate this coming Holy Week, we recognize and declare the presence of the King of Peace, the Savior King. And from this day on forward, we will shout the real Hosanna and say, Hosanna to the King of Peace, Hosanna to the Savior, King, Savior King, Hosanna to the unexpected King. And may I invite you to please stand. Hold your palm, lips, and on top of your voice, let us shout this all together, recognizing the presence of our Lord Jesus in our lives and praying that all people, most especially people in the darkest moments, would also say, Hosanna, King of Peace, save us. All together, let's shout, Hosanna to the King of Peace. Hosanna to the Savior King. Hosanna to the unexpected King. Amen. Let us continue to stand as we have our affirmation of faith. Together, I believe in God the Creator, who made me and all things, who set me on my path in this world. I believe in God the Savior, who is one with the Creator, who rescued me and all creation from the depredation of our violations against God and creation. This man, Jesus of Nazareth, the Christ, walked a path through this world, taking on human form, having been born on a woman through the power of the Holy Spirit. He lived and worked in this world among people just like me. He walked God's path to death on a cross and rose from the dead to open our pathway to eternal life. I believe in God the Holy Spirit, my counselor and guide, who is one with the Creator and the Christ, who through the body and blood of Jesus brings me into communion with all people, past, present, and future, who calls me to walk a sacred way of life through this world, caring for creation and the people I meet on the way, loving them, helping them, welcoming them without prejudice, being God's hand and feet in the world. Amen. Let us have our offering as we hear an offertory number through Erica. Thank you. For our hymn of thanksgiving and dedication, let us sing All Glory, Laud, and Honor. Into God's world, humble and kind.
We will be faithful, gracious, and true.
Go into God's world, gracious and loving, and let us bring Christ's peace to the world. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Oh Lord, now let your servant
as we carry Pastor Jan's message out into the world this week, let us join together and sing Jesus Messiah.
He became sin who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and carried the cross. Love so amazing, love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer. Broken and poured out, all for love. The whole world trembled and the world was torn. Love so amazing, love so amazing, yeah. Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel. From heaven, Jesus Messiah.